I'm Stephen, welcome to Steety Films, and happy holidays to all of yous. Then it is gift giving is a whole different topic, and what are yours going to get for Christmas? I don't know, because gift giving can be quite hard, I should say, but you never know what you're going to get. But it's nice to get whatever gifts you're going to get given, even if it is essentials from your mum. Yeah, I do love essentials from my mum either way. But yeah, I thought I'd share some gift giving ideas, even if it's for males, for geeks. You know, male for geeks, I should say, because I'm a male and a geek and all that jazz. Anyways, so here are my top 5 gift sets. Let's get to it. Now, let me just wrap up these disclaimers for gift giving. I'm sure someone will appreciate some disclaimers for as a gift. But yeah, sorry that these are just mostly for male geeks, I should say, but there are some essentials that are in these, you know, gift-giving kind of gifts. But they are quite cool, though, for the male geeks out there and all that are interested in these certain gifts. Anyways, quick with jibber-jabber, let's go on with number 5, and that is links. Yes, links. For those people that don't know, links is a, you know, product, because most people can be smelly and all that, and it's a traditional thing here in the UK, but usually links is being pronounced axe in different regions is another thing. But yeah, you can get like certain products with certain gifts. I remember getting like a rechargeable battery one time, but yeah, there's nothing else to say, but basically you get like some smelly stuff, nice smelly stuff, and a gift with it. So that's number 5, and at number 4 is Loot Crate. Now, the proper Loot Crate subscription is still a thing nowadays, which surprisingly still lives. And then it's products is another thing. Because I got like this really kind of expensive-ish lot of geeky stuff, which I don't recommend getting it on Amazon, because you get some randomish stuff. Some of them are Loot Crate exclusives-ish. But there's just a bunch of randomish things, even if it's outdated Loot Crate stuff. And some other particular things, like, why would I need a bird sharpener? Why a bird sharpener? That's not geeky at all. But you get what I mean. But there are some really cool, neat stuff. But I still recommend you going for the proper subscription. Sure, it doesn't cost that very much, so to say, for a Loot Crate. But Loot Crates are still neat-ish, because you get some, like, geeky references that you may get or may not get. Even though that there are some really cool, neat stuff you can get in a Loot Crate subscription. But still, you know, you rather get the proper stuff than the ones you can get randomly, which I still don't recommend at all. So that's number 4. And at number 3 is Call of Duty. This Call of Duty gift set thing. Now, sure, Call of Duty Warzone is still a thing for most people, but I decided to get this. Sure, I'm not much of a Call of Duty fan, even though I do own a copy of this game, which is Call of Duty Black Ops 4. But they do have some nifty, really cool ideas when it comes to this really cool controller stand, which, by the way, is quite a bit small, just to be aware of that. But it's still a nice, nifty thing to have. There's a pen, a badge, and a coin. Then there's this really nice beanie, which is quite good. It's a nice gift set, I should say. There's these gunner-like glasses, which are not so bad, but they don't help you with your eyesight or whatever, or get you play good or whatever. But it's still a nice complete set for those people that are into their Call of Duty. It's still a nice gift set, I should say, for them Call of Duty fans out there, even though I don't play Call of Duty as much. So that's number 3, and then number 2 is a pint set. Buy a pint set, you basically get like this pint glass and other types of bits and bobs, because I've received one of these that I kind of wanted, even though I do use that geek coaster quite often in my desk. But it's a nice thing, and it comes with a bunch of different stuff, including a pint glass. But there are a variety of different stuff like this that has gift sets that have a variety of different stuff. Not just a pint glass, but some other things as well. So that's number 2. And at number 1 is yes, a Yu-Gi-Oh! Deck set. Even this is the same with Pokemon cards as well. But I was tempted to buy a Pokemon mystery pack of them Pokemon cards, but I stumbled across a Yu-Gi-Oh! One. And this has really got me back into playing Yu-Gi-Oh! Because it's been like a year, half a yearish now, since I got back into Yu-Gi-Oh! And this has like some nostalgia, and not including the sleeves sadly, but it has some nostalgia particular cards that Yugi plays throughout his duels in the anime series alone, and I do utilise this in my duels against a friend online, but the deck is quite a bit meh in some cases. But I do like this because it brings back nostalgia for those people that enjoy Yu-Gi-Oh cards, or Pokemon cards, or if you're one of them Magic the Gathering kind of people, then you must be into that. But still, I find a card collecting kind of thing to start off, or rejoice players into card collecting again. But it's up to you, depends on your gift giving scenarios, but it's nice though that I got back into Yu-Gi-Oh because of this, which is a nice constructive deck for you to start off playing Yu-Gi-Oh with. Whew, so those were my top 5 gift sets, hope you enjoyed it. I know there's not much variety, but it's mostly for males and geeks, and it's mostly for myself, I should say, what I'm kind of into nowadays, kind of. But yeah, if you find that special someone, I'm sure it's the thought that counts is another thing. But for those people that do celebrate the holidays and whatever, I hope you have a nice happy holidays. And I hope you guys got what you get, what you're given. That is, even if it is a Yu-Gi-Oh! Blooming cards. Which I don't mind either way, even though that it's nice I got back into Yu-Gi-Oh! But you'd have to pick that though as number one, but you know, that's me in a nutshell, because nowadays loads of people like their Pokemon cards is another thing. Anyways, I'm really going to the tangent now. We'll leave it at that now. Anyways, I better go now. See you from Steety Films.